aquí yo vice chancellor profesor Dr. D. Kamaruddin Dimuri, to our guest speaker Dr. Sanjaya Mishra from the Commonwealth of Learning Canada, pegawai utama university yang berbahagia TNC HEPA from Dr. Ismail Ali, to our chief librarian Wan Dayang Rukia, to deans of faculties, to director of centers, to deputy deans, deputy directors, head of department, ladies and gentlemen, a very good morning. And salam sejahtera, and salam smart Eco Campus. And a very warm welcome to this workshop on policy development for technology and enabled learning in UMS. First and foremost, we would like to express our appreciation to our Vice Chancellor, Professor Dato D. Kamaruddin Dimuri, for taking time off your very busy schedule to be with us for this very auspicious occasion and to officiate this workshop. Dato, terima kasih. Because we understand that it is something official, and but he will time for us. Thank you. This workshop is also jointly organized by three centers. That is the Center for E-Learning, Pusat E-Pembelajaran. We're also the Center for Teaching Excellence and Academic Quality, our PKBKA. And also the Department of Information Technology and Communication, our GTNK. Our appreciation is extended to our very experienced and our very esteemed consultant and facilitator, Dr. Sanjaya Mishra. Thank you for making time out of your tight schedule also, Dr. Sanjaya, to come all the way from Vancouver, Canada, to be with us. Dr. Sanjaya happens to be an old friend more than 20 years ago when I was in his workshop, where he was actually the consultant for the World Bank Institute concerning technology. At that time it was called technology and distance mentoring. Thank you. So my sifu. On the 29th of January this year, UMS signed an agreement with Commonwealth of Learning, and through this agreement, the Commonwealth of Learning will provide support to UMS for the next 3 years, at least 3 years, to undertake a systematic approach to institutionalize technology-enabled learning through research, through consultation, through capacity building, and monitoring and also evaluation. So it's a very scientific approach of our partnership. We call it smart partnership. Today, we are involved in the first workshop. It's called a visioning workshop for technology enabled learning policy. So a very special thank you also, I'd like to wish to our organizing committee members. We have our, in this committee, Deputy Director of our Center for E-Learning, Dr. Liu Tok Seng. Thank you for all the hard work. Dr. Kenneth Francis Rodrigue. Thank you. And our Kwan Saumi Jemun, our coordinator for Blended Learning and Training, for all the wonderful work done. Our E-Learning coordinators across all the faculties. Elizabeth Malanjun, our center's manager. Thank you, and her team. So for all the special effort and time in planning and arrangement, a big thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, allow me now just to brief, very briefly, concerning how we come up to this point of conducting a workshop. I will use the PowerPoint slide So if you look at the slide in three screens, you will see that the timeline of actually using technology in UMS started way back in the year 2000, where we have a media and education technology unit. In 2006, we started having a center for academic development. In 2009, we have the UMS e-learning committee and the e-learning implementation and monitoring committee. It was a committee. And in 2011, there was the National E-Learning Policy 1.0. This is called the DEPAN, WSI1, where the KPI on how technology should be implemented and the expected result by the Ministry of Higher Education was in this version 1. In 2014, we had the second version, which is the one that we are still using right now. And in 2014, in response to this National E-Learning Policy of version 2, we have the e-learning unit UMS established. And at that time, the head was our professor, Dr. Tan Jun Feng. And in 2017, we upgraded the unit to become a center for e-learning UMS. So just a very brief history of what transpired. On the 1st of October, the Center for E-Learning UMS was established under the initiation of our Vice Chancellor. And on the 2nd of November, we conducted a SWOT analysis among the faculty's e-learning coordinators. So as a result, we came up with an e-learning strategy and action plan, version 1. Then we conducted a SWOT analysis across all faculties. It was open to each and every individual academic staff, okay, to put in the comment, apakah kelemahan, apakah kelebihan, apakah ancaman-ancaman, what are the opportunities that we should explore. So from the many hundreds of comments that we received, we came up with e-learning strategy and action plan version 2, and this is actually our Harap Hidup for smart e-learning in UMS. Then on 29 January, the agreement was signed between UMS and the Commonwealth of Learning, where there is now an initiation into the systematic approach to institutionalize technology-enabled learning in UMS. We say institutionalized because there are actually many, many champions in different places in Sino. So now we are looking at how we could actually systematically and scientifically bring everybody into institutionalized. So from the 4th to the 15th of March, we have a campus-wide baseline survey of technology and enabled learning, where over 299 academic staff responded, and we have over 979 students responded. So there were altogether 3 surveys that were conducted within this period of time across, okay, all the 3 campuses. So today is the 19th of March, and for the next 2 days, we are having this workshop on policy development for technology and digital learning. And this workshop will be based on all the data that were collected from the surveys from the students as well as from our lecturers. So they are all very empirical. Just a very brief history again. So out of these analyses, we have all these comments coming from our lecturers. And then what we did was, we did some analysis and we recategorized them. And we came up actually with the strategies in our Harap Hidup e-learning from the response of actually all our lecturers. So that is where we came up with strategy for staff training. We have a new approach to it. For student training, we have a new approach to it. So out of all these strategies, we then came up with action plan. So all the action plan, they are all together 22. So this is a summary of actually the S1 until S7. These are the 7 strategic plans for our smart e-learning UMS. And out of each of these strategies, they are action plan. So what we want to do and how we are going to do it will be actually all the action plan. So, from here, and the way forward, we believe, okay, that as we based and berdasarkan our Depan 2.0, we are also based upon our Malaysian Education Blueprint, because Sandra is also very familiar. And every year, our Minister of Higher Education will also have a yearly speech to give us some guidelines. So you probably have seen this diagram also. And together with our Center for E-Learning, which is also our UMS, Smart E-Learning Hala 7, and also from PKPKA, a lot of documents with regard to teaching and learning. So we hope that together, this policy will be able to encompass and make it holistic. Okay? Together also with our JTMK, our ICT department. So, Dr. Sanjaya, to me, is a very heavy work put on your shoulder. So thank you for coming all the way from Canada to help integrate all this together for us. So this is our workshop today. So in conclusion, we hope that the development of this policy will stand out, okay, as a commitment by each and every academic staff, each and every every staff of UMS, okay, to ensure that we have to be able to nurture quality teaching and learning among our new generation of UMS graduates, and more important, to prepare them towards the future, an unknown future, and we will be able to prepare them for a future through graduates, as well as we call it Industry 4.0 ready, which I'm not too familiar about the definition of it yet. So I wish everyone a very productive and enjoyable time. Thank you.